Was it really 5 years ago? It hasn't changed at all. Well, why should it? I remember the last time we were here, the three of us. It was one of those wonderful days you get in early spring, when suddenly you're sure it's going to be a perfect summer. By that evening, all Phyllida's freckles had come out, and she got terribly cross as she had a date.
Right. I'm off then. I won't be late. Hey, cheer up, Dad. It was a lovely day.
I thought it had been a lovely day, too. I hadn't even noticed what Mark had been going through. That shows how insensitive I've become. I mean, when he said our life was boring and suburban and middle-aged, I could see what he meant. But I hadn't any idea. No idea at all. So I can hardly make a big production of it now.
Bridget, we have to talk.
I'm listening. This is the trickiest bit.
I didn't spend last night in Birmingham. I spent it in Putney.
But we don't know anyone in Putney.
Her name's Rebecca. She's a journalist. She's a bit younger than I am. Well, a lot, really. It doesn't matter. I'm trying to think of a way to tell you this kindly, but there isn't one. Bridget, I'm in love, and Rebecca seems to love me.
All I could think of was the fact that I bought turbot for supper. And, you know, one can hardly ever get it these days, and Mark did like it so. And I read all that hollandaise, and I thought, oh, dear, our lovely dinner's going to be wasted. So when he told me about this girl, I said, oh, yes, I see. Oh, thank you for telling me. And that was all. And we ate the turbot. And you know, I quite enjoyed it. So, I mean, there's no point in putting on a tragic act. It stands to reason nobody, but nobody that greedy, has much dignity to stand on. What did you think, Mrs. Mayor, when your husband told you he was in love with another woman? I thought about turbot.